Hello friends, in this video I am gonna show you how to set up your cadence for the 45 nanometer design kit and simulate a simple inverter design. So you already have access to this file from Blackboard. It's available on the Blackboard, you can download that. So just follow all these steps and you will have your cadence pin set up. So first step is we need to log in into the Seekate server using our eReader credentials. The second step says mkdir cadence, which is make directory command. This is just to make your folder quite organized. You can keep your cadence file in cadence folder, hspice file in hspice folder. So mkdir, this will create a new folder cadence in your directory. Now with the third step is change directory, cd is change directory. I'm going into that newly created folder cadence. Now I am into that folder cadence. Then I need to copy this file from this directory into my current location. The command for that is given in this fourth step. So that is cp data. Just write the few keywords or few initial letters and press tab. The complete world will automatically be populated. Make sure you put this dot at the end of this command. This dot actually specifies that I need to copy this setup.sh into my current directory, which is cadence. Now that command has been run. ls is actually a command to look into the contents of your folder. So if I just issue ls, now that you can see that setup.sh has been copied. Now I need to change my shell. csh is basically a command to change the shell from bash to c shell. Presently I'm working on a bash, so as to convert it to C is this command. Yes. The second, I need to source that copied file. This file actually have few commands into it which automatically get run when you source this. So I source that. Everything now that I need for my simulation as well as for cadence to work on is in place. So I'm just going to launch cadence now. Make sure at this point of time you have your Xming being running at backend, because only then your cadence window will pop up. Now you can see that the cadence has been shown at the back. This cadence installation version is 6.1, which is a newer one, and this is that information. You can close that, not much use. So this is my cadence window. Now I'm gonna show you how to make a simple inverter and how to simulate it on HSPICE. This design kit has been designed for HSPICE simulator only, so we can't use Spectre for the simulation of our design. Moreover, the model libraries and everything that will be now available in your directory. So first of all, I need to create my own library. I name it as demo. I need to attach this library to the technology library, which is nothing but 45 nanometer and available to me. Okay, now you can see that demo has been appeared in this library list. Now under this library, I can keep my multiple designs. For example, NOT, NAND, whatever design you want to do, you can keep that. For that, I need to go into, after selecting that library, demo, go to file, new, cell view. Cell view means a one such file in this particular folder demo. So I'm just gonna show you how to simulate a simple inverter, and this is a schematic. Okay, yes, now it will open a schematic editor for you, wherein you can place your transistors and interconnect them as per the inverter design. So just to select the transistor I, if you press I on your keyboard, I is actually for add instance. So this browse. Two types of libraries are available to you. One in which you can find your transistors. Another one has the information about the different metal layers and the vias which you will be using during the layout generation, or when you want to draw a layout for your design. So I'm just gonna simulate inverter in a schematic version only. So even in, like, you may find the multiple flavors of the transistors available to you. VTH specially means high threshold. VTL stands for low threshold. VTG stands for near threshold. I prefer to use the low threshold inverters for my transistors for my inverter. Selected PMOS, place it on the top. Now I need an NMOS as well. I need to go into that library again. To cancel that, you can press escape. Now I need to do some interconnection. I need a wire. Pressing W will select the wire. Double click at the destination point will end up your connection. Otherwise, you may observe that it will be continued. Like I did a single click and it is like not been canceled. So I did a double click. Now it's been. This is for my output. This is for my input. Now I need to place the pins for my input and output. Input. Its direction is output. Now I need to have my VDD and ground as well. So again, for VDD and ground, I need to go into this analog libraries, sources, the sources globals. Here is VDD. So here I connect the VDD. For ground, I need to go into the same library. Here is the ground. And yeah, that's it. So my inverter design is complete. Now I will check for any warnings or errors in my design. Oh, I haven't connected body to any point. So let's correct that. Body of PMOS to be connected to VDD and NMOS to ground. Moreover, I need to change the parameter of my PMOS since I know in my inverter the width of PMOS is twice as compared with NMOS. So select the transistor and press Q. Q will actually take you into the properties of that transistor wherein you can alter the different parameters. Like I am going to change the width of that to twice. Do not change the length. It is a minimum length with which you can design your circuit. Of course you can increase it, but don't put up the value less than 50 nanometer, because otherwise your simulation will not be correct. So yep, I make all those modification and now my circuit seems good. Let me check it again for the errors. Nothing popped up now, so my design is correct. Now I need to simulate my design. For simulate, go to launch ADL. Yes, first step, I need to select the simulator. Either I want my design to simulate with Spectre or HSPICE. Spectre is not available for this design kit, so I select HSPICE. Okay. After selecting the simulator, I need to put up the different model libraries. So if you do the browse, you'll find this HSPICE folder in your directory. Go into this. Three model files are available to you. One is FF, which is fast, other one nominal. The third one is slow. Usually prefer to go for the nominal one. Now I need to give my inputs and VDD supply. For that, I go to stimuli, inputs. I need to give a pulse to my input. So I select the function to be pulse. This is the voltage one. This particular design kit is designed for a VDD voltage of 1.1. So make sure you are not sourcing the voltage beyond this value. So 1.1 volt is the optimum value for the 45 nanometer technology. So I keep the period 50 nanoseconds. Rise time to be 10 pico, pulse width 25 nanoseconds, so that my duty cycle is 50%. After that, make sure you click this enable and then apply. If you don't click this enable, it won't be enabled. You just put up the values, but it won't be active. For VDD, I go to this globals DC 1.1 volts. enable apply. Okay, now I have given a pulse to my input and a DC supply to my VDD as well. After that, I need to tell my simulator how long I want my design to simulate. So taking the arbitrary value, I want my simulation to go till 100 nanoseconds with a step of 1 nanoseconds. And I want something graphical description of my design. So I go to plot outputs to be plotted, select on design, which will actually allow me to to view the different waveforms in my simulation window. So I want my input waveform to appear and output waveform to be appeared at the simulation graph. So I connected all these things. I can find these two options being populated over here. So yeah, that's it. I need to just select my simulator, browse the model libraries, give the stimulus and my time period for how long I want my simulation to proceed, and the waveforms, which all waveforms I need to appear at the output. So thereafter, just this run. It's running at the back end. Now you can find that you have a few graphs or waveforms available with you. So just to make them separate, you can do this split all stripes. So you can make this separate. You can see that this is my input waveform and this is my output waveform. So my inverter is functionally correct because it's like inverting my input waveforms. And if the background doesn't suit you, you can change the background color as well. Go into the graph properties, background, make it white or whatever the color you want to be. So like it's more visible now. So this is all about using this HSpice as a simulator for your design. Moreover, if you are simulating your design in Spectre, you have a calculator available with you with which you can fetch out the different power measurements and time measurement. You can extract the information out of the graph only by zooming into the waveforms. But since we are using HSpice, it's more of a scripting simulation. Every parameter you need to know about, you need to script that. And now I'm going to show you how to extract the power requirement for this design. For that, let me close the window. I'll do this simulation once again. So for that, I have one file been set up. So I just browse that file. In that file, I have kept the two commands for the power measurement. Let me copy that file once. So that file is actually available at this location. Put a dot at the end because I want that file to be copied to my present location, which is Cadence. That has been copied. Now I ask you ls command just to look. Now you can see that file has been copied. Just to look into this command, I can show you can use either nano or vi, whatever the editor you want to use. So this is my that file. You can see that in this file I just kept the to measure the average power and the peak power, and the time is from 0 nanosecond to the end time. This actually I need to fill in whatever the time, since I want my design to simulate for 100 nanosecond. I remove this end time with 100 nanosecond value. This should be same actually with whatever the value you put in your choose when you are simulating your design. So yeah, I updated it accordingly. I go to my design again. Launch, select the simulator, setup, select simulator as HSpice, put up the model files, nominal. Give the stimulus. There's only one input, that's why you are just getting one option. If there are multiple inputs, you may find all those inputs being available. So for the first input, or the only input available to me, I need to give the pulse 1.1 volts. make sure you click this enable, apply. Then I go to the global sources for giving a voltage to my VDD. I give it a DC supply of 1.1 volt, enable that, apply. You can see that the value has been appeared. Okay. Now for the power, there is a one more option in the setup, is the simulation files. Go to that. Under the stimulus file, you can put up the different files. For example, just for this demo, I have the power measurement file with me. You can even put up the commands for the delay measurement and browse that file as well. So this is my that file. I put this file under the stimulus files. Here it is. Okay. Analysis, choose for how long my design to simulate, 0 to 100. I put here the same value that I have put in my script on the step with the step size of 1 nanoseconds. Outputs to be plotted, select on design which all waveforms I want to look at my simulation graphs. I have selected this. These two things are been popped up or populated here. Just everything has been done now. Now I click this green button which is netlist and run. These are the same waveforms we have seen earlier as well. So just to make them separate, split all strips. So this is my input and this is my output. And now you need to go to your simulation log for just to know about the power measurements. If you browse it over here, here it is. Now you can find that you have the both the readings available to you. My average power for this design is 3.5 × 10⁻⁸ watts, and which is from 0 to 100 nanoseconds, and my peak power is 6.522 × 10⁻⁵ watts, and it is observed at this particular time stamp, which falls between 0 to 100 nanoseconds. So yeah, this is how you can fetch the different parameters for your design, like power and delay. And you can even create your netlist file as well. For example, you just need to draw a circuit in the cadence and want to know about the circuit description as per the HSPICE format. So for that, let me close this. You can go to the simulation, netlist, create netlist. So since we have selected our simulator to be HSPICE, so this netlist is created as per the HSPICE format. Now you can see that this transistor description is same as what we used to have in the different files provided by the professors earlier. So I have just used the two transistors. These are my two transistors and these are how they've been interconnected with the different parameters of them. And this is what the file I have included. So if you have a complex circuit, you can refrain yourself from writing the circuit description and use a cadence with the HSPICE simulator to get that. And just put up your delay and power measurements instructions or commands into that, so as you can be having your complete HSPICE script and you can run it separately on the HSPICE simulator. So this is all what I have for this tutorial. Feel free to contact if you do find any troubles in simulating your design. Tutors are there to help you. Thank you. Thanks for watching.